I love all types of music. Most people say I'm a true music geek. I like to say I'm a true music genius. I created so many Pandora stations that I reached the max you're allowed to have. Don't even ask me how many it was. But no matter what, my favorite instrument is the guitar. I love everything about it, from its sweet, tender sound to its smooth, sexy shape. It allows me to create a simple but meaningful rhythm to go along with the honest poetry of the lyrics. The best advice my grandpa gave me before he died was that the guitar has strings that connect to the heart. They allow you to play the music that's inside of you. And as long as it's truthful, it will be beautiful. So why the hell is it taking me so long to write this damn song? It's gonna look great right above my bed. Just wait. It'll be the first thing I see when I wake up every morning and the last image I have before I go to bed. Maybe it'll give me inspirations for my designs. I wanna make something so awesome, it'll be recognized by Prada. I'll be a famous designer. And it'll be all thanks to Mr. Tatum.
Who?
Channing Tatum. Duh.
Oh no.
Oh yes.
No.
Why the hell not?
Because he's staring at me.
No, he's staring at me.
Spencer, I'm not comfortable with a naked guy constantly staring at me.
What are you trying to say, Jerry?
That I don't want a naked Channing Tatum staring at me in my room.
Hey, it was my room first. If you aren't comfortable with the living situation, you shouldn't agree to stay here.
Give it a break, Spencer. You're not about to pull the homophobe card on me.
I'm just saying. I mean, I wouldn't have an issue if you wanted a poster of Jennifer Lopez.
I know you wouldn't. She's your idol.
You know, Stan never had a problem with my male celebrity posters.
Spencer, that's because Stan was never here. And when he was, it was after a long night of drinking, and he'd be passed out before he even got completely through the door.
Don't try and change the subject. Channing stays.
Whatever, Spence. You know, I can't believe he got kicked out of school.
Well, that tends to happen when you get caught smoking pot in the dorm study lounge.
You still haven't finished Liz's song yet?
You know, it's not that easy to write a song.
Sure it is. All you gotta do is...
Spencer, don't you have a, I don't know, sweater to go make or a date with your boyfriend or something?
No. Well, we broke up yesterday.
Oh. Sorry.
It's whatever. You know, I think I will take it down. It is like he's staring.
Sorry.
Your foot wasn't looking fast going either.
That's why people don't like skateboarders.
Thanks.
You sure you're okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. I was... Oh no, now I'm gonna be late.
I think it's been like 15 minutes.
No, I have to get on class early to mentally prepare and warm up and look over my music. And now I'm never gonna be on time.
I can't know. I'm sorry.
It's not your fault. I
was gonna look where I was going. And
going over music in my head and... Whoa.
You okay? Do you need me to walk you to the health center?
I gotta know. Church would be more appropriate.
What?
I gotta get to class.
Wait, I didn't even get your name.
I'm thinking it's best if you don't.
I'm Jacob. Now your turn.
I'm thinking maybe you should get on your skateboard and go about your way in the other direction.
Please?
Listen, Jacob, I'm sure you're a nice guy, but I just gotta get to class right now. I'm sorry I ran into your skateboard, but unless you're planning on filing a report, you don't need to know my name, okay?
Oh, come on. What could have hurt? Ah!
Get away!
Is that Stan Phillips?
It sure is.
What's that skunk doing?
Somebody get this thing away from me!
Somebody's gotta help him.
If we alarm that thing in any way, Stan's as much as skunked.
Stan!
Ginger?
I'm gonna help you.
So your name's Ginger. Nice to meet you. How do you know Stan Phillips?
An old friend. Who? Oh, for heaven's sakes!
What are you doing?
If I can get it to turn around, you can run away.
That won't work. That thing has it out for me.
What on earth did you do to it?
Nothing. I just threw a rock at it.
Jeez, really? Come here. Come here, boy. Look over here.
Ginger, I don't think it's how you...
Jacob, I can drop this off.
Four times today. She says hi, by the way.
Tell her I say hi. My fashion show's next week.
Uh-huh.
We're expecting representatives from a big agency.
Good luck.
Hey, Tommy. Hey, what's going on, man?
You be at the party tonight, right?
No, you know it.
Some of the guys are having a party tonight. I'll be by to pick you up around 9.
Wonderful.
Are you okay?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Why wouldn't I be?
I don't know. You seem quiet.
What's there to talk about, Tommy?
I don't know. What do you got going on this weekend?
I just told you.
Oh, yeah.
Hi, Tommy.
Hey, girls. Liz, wait up.
And what makes you think that I want to go to this stupid party anyway?
I'm sorry?
Okay, you want to talk? Let's talk. When's my birthday?
What?
When's my birthday?
It's, March.
What's my middle name?
Oh.
And how long have we been together?
Since freshman year.
Yeah. But I bet you can't even remember when freshman year.
Okay, what's the point of all this, Liz?
The point is, what's the point of even talking? You're not even gonna listen.
It's my mom.
Call her back.
It's my mom.
Call her back.
Hello?
What the hell?
Mom, I'll call you back.
Why do you have this?
Come on.
Why was it in your backpack?
I don't know. It's probably in there from last semester.
So you haven't gotten high since Halloween?
No. I quit.
So you remember what? Sentimental reasons?
I quit, Liz. Damn it! They already have my mom, tired damn team, coach, all breathing down my back. I don't need you too. Liz, I'm sorry I said that. I didn't mean it.
Jerry! Hi!
Liz, hi!
How are you?
I'm great. How are you?
Awesome. Hey, Spencer.
Hey, Liz.
Liz, come on. I don't want to be late for class.
Hey, Tommy.
Geek? I mean, what's up, jerk?
Okay. Tommy, that's not cool.
What's wrong with wanting to be on time for class?
Hey, how's my song coming along?
Oh, you know what? It's going along great. It's almost finished.
Oh, wow, I appreciate it. Thank you. You know, I know it was only one music class, but I really feel something for these lyrics.
Liz!
In a minute!
Hey, don't worry. I'm going to make sure that it sounds perfect.
Thanks.
Hey, if you want to stay here with Guitar Hero and Queer Eye, then that's fine with me.
Tommy!
Hey, that's not cool, man.
And what the hell are you going to do about it?
Wow, a jock boy and a music major and a gay. That's real original, Tommy. I didn't know we were on Glee now.
You know what? Screw this. I'm going to class.
You look much smarter from further away, BTW.
Spencer, are you crazy?
What? If he touches me, I'll charge him with a hate crime. One of the joys of being out of the closet.
Listen, I'm sorry about him. He can be a real ass sometimes.
Sometimes?
Okay, well, listen, I gotta get going, but there's a party tonight off the Sandstone. You guys should come by.
Yeah, I don't know.
And be around more idiots like Tommy. No offense, girl.
They wouldn't bother you.
Listen, thanks for the offer, but I'm probably just gonna stay in and finish your song tonight.
Your sweetheart. Aw, all right. See you guys later. Bye, Spencer.
You are pathetic.
What?
You're like a deer in the headlights. It's clear as day that you like her.
Liz? No, Spencer, I'm just doing her a favor. I'm a musician. I write music.
And you're also hopelessly in love with the basketball player's girlfriend. It's like when the...
Look, I don't like her like that.
Yeah, and I don't like guys. We're gonna be late.
You got sprayed by a skunk, are you okay?
Oh yeah, I'm great, you know, just got kicked out of rehearsal because I smell so horrid and everybody keeps on giving me weird looks and I don't know how to get rid of the smell, but aside from that, I'm fine.
What all have you tried?
I've tried everything. I just took my 7th shower and nothing's worked. My skin's hurting from scrubbing so hard.
I'm so sorry.
I'll be fine, as long as I'm allowed in finals next week.
I'm sure you'll be just fine.
So, how are you?
Well, you know. Same as usual. Tommy and I got into another argument today.
Oh, goodness.
I found a lighter in his bag.
Wait, I thought he stopped smoking pot.
He said he did. But I don't know. I mean, whenever I ask him about it, he just gets pissed. I mean, it seems like lately we're either arguing or just not talking.
Liz, this has been going on since last year.
I know.
Why are you still with him?
I mean, when you've been with someone for as long as Tommy and I have been together, it's hard to just let it go, Ginger.
But if you're not happy?
It's more complicated than that. I can't just end things. I mean, I wish I had the strength you have.
What do you mean?
You don't have to be with anyone, you know? You're okay with just the person you are. You don't have to be afraid to go for what you want.
Well, the whole dating game really isn't for me. I mean, I've got way too much on my plate to worry about something like that.
Well, hey, I have to get ready for this party. Good luck with that skunk odor.
Thanks. Be safe. Bye.
What's up, Chomp?
Stan, what are you doing here?
Can't your best friend stop by and say hello?
You're not even allowed on campus.
There's a lot of things I'm not allowed to do. Doesn't stop me from doing it, though.
Where's Spence?
He went out.
With Ryan?
No, they broke up.
Oh, you don't say. Damn, I move out of everything goes to hell.
Hey, well, next time, don't smoke pot in the study lounge and you won't have to move anywhere.
Don't lecture me, man. I got in enough from my old man already. Why can't you be like everyone else in your family? Do something with your life. Well, tell me this. If I'm such a disgrace, why does that bastard still give me money for my own place? So, what are you doing at home on a Friday night?
Working on a song.
Of course. Well, you're more than welcome to join me at that basketball party off Sandstone. I've got some business to tend to there anyway.
I've already been invited, but thanks.
So why the hell aren't you going? Finish that stupid song some other time.
Hey, don't call it stupid.
I'm just saying, you never have fun anymore.
This song is for someone.
Mm-hmm.
For a girl.
Oh. Let me guess. You like this girl, decided to write her a song, but you still haven't told her you like her yet.
Actually, she wrote the song. She just asked me to set it to music.
But you still haven't told her that you like her yet.
It's a little more complicated than that.
Got it.
It really is, man.
How, she has a boyfriend or something? Uh-huh. Well, does she like you?
I'm not too sure.
Does she like you?
Maybe.
I'm gonna damn stop.
Hey, stop!
Are you freaking kidding me? This song is about you.
No, it's not about me.
It's called My Little Guitar Player.
So what?
Man, don't be a wuss. Get your girl, man. Who cares if she has a boyfriend?
I don't know, Stan. He's pretty big.
Who is he?
Well, that's the thing.
Who is he, man?
Tommy Adams.
The basketball player.
Don't laugh.
That son of a bitch.
I take it you don't like him?
I can't stand his freaking guts, and I hope, for your sake, that she's smarter than her boyfriend is.
You know, I really should just forget about it.
To hell with giving up. Man, get your girl, man. If not for you, do it for me. I'd love to see that stupid look on Tommy's face anyway. Anyway, I'll catch you later, man.
Oh, you should call up.
Goodbye, Stan.
Habit, aren't we?
I'm sorry, I... Oh, good God in heaven.
Oh, I know I reeked, don't I? Have any luck getting it out?
I'm going to hell.
What?
I mean, no, it's still there.
Yeah, I didn't have any luck either. Hey, sorry about all this. I can't help but feel like it's my fault.
It's fine, I just thought I could help Stan.
Can't scare the poor guy.
No, don't worry. I'm gonna go to my room and pray. Or something.
Right.
Bye.
Until we bump into each other again.
Oh my God, Ginger! You okay, what happened?
I slipped! God, it hurts!
Let me see it.
No, get away! Don't touch it!
I won't.
It hurts!
Looks like I might have sprained.
How would you know?
Today wasn't the first day I fell off the skateboard.
Now how am I gonna go to finals? I have to perform next week! How in the world am I gonna do color guard finals?
Well, first things first is get to the hospital and get this checked out.
No, I'm fine. Just let me lay here for a sec.
You need to get checked out.
I can't even walk.
You need to get to the hospital. Here.
Jacob, please stop. Jacob,
Ginger,
stop.
Let me cure
you. Jacob, just stop it. Jacob.
Ginger, you got some scratch.
Where is your towel?
Oh, down there.
Oh Lord, you're naked. Put me down! Put me down right now, Jacob! Put me down! Put me down! Put me down right now!
I'm so sorry.
Hey, how are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm pretty good.
How long have you worked here?
Oh, I just started last week.
Great.
Hey, do you have a sec? I've got a few minutes before my shift starts.
Sure.
Listen, Spencer, I know it's really none of my business.
Yeah, you're gonna talk to me about Ryan anyway.
Well, he is my little brother. Have you thought about talking to him?
Why would I want to talk to him?
Because he's left you like 20 voicemails.
And all 20 have been deleted.
He can't even watch a Channing Tatum movie without getting upset.
Good for him.
Don't you think he at least deserves a chance to apologize?
You're joking, right?
Spencer.
I mean, why would I give him any of my time? He cheated on me, Rita. You understand that, right?
I know that.
Then why would I talk to him? He cheated on me with some drunk straight guy at a party he lied about going to in the first place. And then didn't even tell me until a week later.
But he still loves you.
That's not my problem. I've moved on. See how he likes to get hit in the face with a brick. That's what it feels like.
We have nothing left to discuss.
He told you the truth because he didn't want to hide anything from you. You two were so happy together. How can you go and throw all of that away? I like you, Spencer. You were good for Ryan.
It's very flattering, Rita. It is. But Ryan and I are over. I will not be with someone who is unfaithful to me.
I'm done, Rita.
You said you moved on. Are you sure?
Leave it alone.
Everyone makes mistakes. If you loved him too, you'd know how to forgive him.
One drink I'm missing it, bro.
Man, after last week's game, everybody wants a piece of us. I ain't never seen as many people here before.
I know. But that's good, though. It lets us know we're doing our jobs.
Right?
There you are. I'm looking everywhere for you.
What do you need?
How long are we going to be here?
Don't tell me you're ready to go now. We've only been here for 15 minutes.
It's 14 minutes too long.
Go make friends or something.
You know this isn't my scene.
Yeah, but it's mine. So can't we have fun for tonight?
What?
I mean, can we not argue in front of my team and my friends? No embarrassment. Just can we have fun for tonight? And then I'll take you home later.
Whatever you want, Tommy.
Liz, hi. I hope I'm not disturbing anything.
No, not at all. What's up?
Okay, I know you're at your party and all that, but I finished your song.
No way! Thank you so much, Jerry.
Hey, it's no problem. I thought that you might want to come by and hear it. Tonight. Liz? Are you there?
I wish I could. But I can't.
Hey, I understand. It's no problem. It was stupid of me to ask.
No, Jerry, wait.
Don't worry about it. Just let me know when you have time to hear it, okay? I'll see you later.
The star basketball player has arrived. The party can really start now.
What do you want, Stan?
Oh, I don't know. Maybe for you to tell the truth.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Mm-hmm.
But if I did, this wouldn't be the time or the place.
Oh, I think this would be the perfect time and place at a party where there's plenty of people around, especially people from the basketball team, all who could hear that you were the one smoking with me in the study lounge.
Lower your voice.
You're a coward, Tommy.
You need to back up.
You hid in a closet and watched them arrest me. And you had plenty of opportunities to tell them that that was your weed in the first place.
And do what? Get expelled? Get kicked off the team? Get arrested? Like you did? See, unlike you, Stan, I have a future. And I'm about to let any of this stuff get in the way of it.
You may as well tell the truth. Because by the time I'm done, everyone's gonna know anyway.
Stan, if you pull any of this stuff.
Man, I ain't scared of you.
Tommy.
Liz.
I'm ready to go now.
Me too. Let's go.
You're Liz. Tommy's girlfriend.
Yeah.
I'm an old friend of Tommy's. We used to go way back. Thick as thieves, me and him.
I didn't know you were friends with Stan Phillips.
I'm not. Let's go.
Tommy boy and me used to waste a day away, smoking bowl after bowl. Until we couldn't even remember our own names.
Man, I swear to God.
As a matter of fact, I recall that night in the study lounge, he was with me. Actually, yeah, that's right.
Come on.
The weed was his. Isn't that something?
You promised.
Because I was going
to
tell you.
Oh, come on, Tommy.
You lied to me?
Wouldn't be the first time.
Shut up. How could you?
Liz, I'm sorry.
You know what? I'll find my own ride home.
Liz,
Liz! Liz! Lies ruin everything, don't they?
Son of a bitch.
What you want, man? What's up? What's up, man?
Closet?
Yeah.
I remember a saying I heard once. Count your blessings, not your worries.
You're religious yourself?
Not really, but that saying always stuck with me.
And what's my blessing from today?
Me.
You can take me home now.
Come off it, Ginger. You like me.
I'm ready to go home.
Come on, I'm not that oblivious.
Don't know what you mean.
Why are you pretending?
I don't date, I don't fall in love. I'm in love with my music, and I don't have time for anything else.
Is that what you've been telling yourself? Does it make it any easier?
Don't pretend like you know me.
I want to get to know you.
I'm not interested in you, Jacob. I'm sorry.
I mean, we ran to each other twice in the same day, both got sprayed by a skunk, had a little fiasco in the hall.
Oh, don't remind me of that.
And instead of having one of your friends take you to the ER, you called me.
What's your point?
My point is that fate, or whatever you want to call it, is practically throwing us together. Now, I don't know why or what it is, but from the moment that I ran into you with my skateboard, I felt something for you.
You sure it wasn't anger for me making you eat pavement?
No, it definitely wasn't that. Even after everything that's happened today, it really has been a good day. That's because I met you. And that's my blessing for today.
Just the dream. What is real? Just a dream. Wouldn't you catch me if I fall out of what I fell? And don't be surprised if I collapse down at your feet again. I don't want to run away from this. I know that I just don't need.